two permits. The first one is Kent Moon at West 1819 Lake Road, Maquoddago. You recall last month, we denied that one on the basis of that did not, well, it didn't comply with the ordinance, but also for a variance and a hardship. The owner did not show a hardship. So what got resubmitted here is now refurbishing of the existing piers there, still staying totally with, not increasing it, the size of it. So I wrote a report on it, dated December 12th, which is today's date. So the facts were, this is the Moon, pier existed prior to 417 Wall, so for the grandfather. Existing pier is 487 square feet, the proposed refurbished pier is 487, so no increase. Since the new pier refurbishment is not enlargement, a new permit is not required. However, registering a new layout is advisable, mostly because the registration was on file and no semblance of actually existing. So a U-shaped deal without any references to the repairing lines at all. This pier is not located in a Lake Beulah sensitive area, so you do not need the input from the DNR on that. So the new pier layout is not being enlarged and can be reconfigured and must be located totally within the repairing zone, so it meets that. The analysis in this one is quite simple. Ordinance chapter 16.10.090 sub 9 says that the pier is grandfathered, repairing or may relocate and reconfigure the pier as long as the pier is not enlarged. Also, the pier does not interfere with the repairing rights of other repairing owners. There's not I recommend approval on this. I think this is a submittal that meets the ordinance number one and number two, even though on its face would require a new permit, meaning that the permit on file is no substitution at all. So, any questions? Move forward, if you're not here, correct?
So Joe, the picture they give us, this hand wrote on it, both piers and one lift for the moon special.
Yes.
So what we have with record is the structures in the repairing zone.
Okay.
And handwritten note that they'll be moved.
Yes, if you look at the pier exhibit, and actually you can see there, the one lift, which would be to the north, is going to be gone. So if you look at the aerial photo, it shows back in 2010, you know, what was there. And that was the wide pier, the narrow pier, and the lift. And that's what's being proposed now, okay? But it is going to be shifted slightly to the south. But it's okay, because it's already 8.5 feet clear of that repairing line. Now, this is an enlargement. Okay, then we have to 12-foot on. So what they decided there is now they're gonna move it over and not put that lift back. So that's the difference. So the pictures, what the survey shows, yeah, what the existing condition was this year. That's my questions? All right, any motion?
I make a motion that we approve the Kent Moon Pier permit at W1819 Lake Road, Maquoddago.
Motion second. Further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? None. Okay. Mark, you're here.
I'm here.
All right. All right. Mark's is a little bit similar, but it's different. So I did a separate analysis on it. First of all, this one is in a DNR sensitive, Lake Beulah sensitive area. So you did get the DNR to review it. And they did a quick job of it and said, as far as they're concerned, they don't even need a permit. Well, according to our ordinance, it does. pure existed prior to 4/17/12, and therefore the grandfather. Existing pure is being enlarged, so a new pure registration is required. The pure registration on file since prior 2005 is no longer representative. The pure is located at sensitive areas, so my analysis was, the only thing that hit me when I first looked at it was, again, we have what's called a sketch that shows 2022 here. You see that the landing there, which they call, in our ordinance, called the loading platform, is 10 by 15. And I was a little worried about that until I checked the ordinance, which we have to do. And it's under 200 square feet, 150 is what it's at. So that was the only thing. This is pretty much in the middle of the property. So the issue really came about when the neighbor, Russell, they're not here, but
no, they're not
here. They made a complaint against Mr. Hospital, and then vice versa, and talked to both parties quite extensively. And the reason that Russell were using or trying to use your peer as an excuse to do something different was, no, totally separate. Everybody got to follow the ordinance, and indeed what you did here is followed. So my analysis says the peer largely includes a loading platform of 150 square foot. Ordinance states the platform cannot exceed 200 square feet. The peer does not interfere with the current rights of other riparian owners. Did not detriment to a public interest. So my recommendation on this was approved. And again, you have a sketch of what's called permit here, which is the new one. You have the email from Ellis's visit from the DNR. You have the registration form. And then what was says from 2005. Ellis is compared it to. Really, just lengthened out a little bit, and the land is a little bigger. As far as the connection short, it's still the same location.
Right. There's a concrete sidewalk where you can't find your
house. Right. So anyway, that's, again, I think this one is, they're getting easier when it complies. If you don't comply, then you have to really check the details. And then we found out that the moon one last month is that you can't ask for a variance, but you have to also demonstrate a hardship, just like the variance that was given in the other time. But the board does have the right, when you have a real top tier one, to try to do that apportionment for the best interest of everyone. So that's the recommendation.
Motion to approve the peer permit at Missouri on my co-pilot's home located at North 9156 on 3 Banning in the 7th District.
Second.
We have a motion to second. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? None. Successful. Thank you for being patient.
Sure. Thank you.
Way, way more than it should have been, but.
Thank you.
Thanks. Okay, we have the police report. Detroit Area Emergency Services District report.
The report was in the packet. There is one thing that I would like to add, and that the Detroit Area Emergency Services District is working with the town of Troy to fill the newly placed hockey and ice skating rinks at Blue Lake. So both departments are working together to provide the water to fill the rinks so that as the temperature freezes, ice skating will be and hockey will be available at Blue Lake. The second thing that's not on the report that was just recently confirmed is that the town of Troy, the town of Lafayette, and the East Troy Area Services District are meeting tomorrow night to readdress the contracts that both of those municipalities have with the fire district. And the last thing that I would like to do is read a letter from Joe DeGaro that was presented to the town of East Troy Board. I would like to personally thank each and every one of you on the town board for selling the town of East Troy's retired police car to the ETA ESP. This saved the district approximately $68,320 in the purchase of a brand new command vehicle, which in turn saved all the district taxpayers a significant amount of money. It is nice to be able to keep our taxpayers' money within the communities and make this a win-win for all. I appreciate the hard work that the town of East Troy board puts in and continue to look forward to working with each of you and serving our great community. Chief DeGarro.
Yeah, I think we all received that. Which,
he was very appreciative. It does help make the budget look better. As Chairman Clarkowski stated last Thursday, Administrator for Walworth County, Roberta, told us that there would be a rebate coming to municipalities. It's a tiered rebate for their purchase of the radios. The radios will eliminate the inability to communicate from one end of the county to another and will help make it easier for the police and the fire districts to work mutual aid calls, which means that multiple departments have to work together to solve the crisis. So I thank the board for putting the police on the radios, putting the DPW on the radios, and helping purchase the radios for the fire district. That's the end of my there is an invoice for the fire truck hose. Let me explain this. We acquired the new fire truck that was not supposed to be taken possession of until 2023. That fire truck came in 2022, which forced the municipality to pay the 2/3 share that we owed for that. However, the fire truck is just the body. It was not equipped with the equipment needed. And the most expensive of that equipment was the hose. When the hose from the previous fire truck was inspected, it did not pass inspection. That hose is inspected, I think it's inspected every other year, and that hose no longer met the state requirements for hose. So we needed to purchase new hose to put on the new fire engine. I believe we also needed to put longer hose than what had been previously used. So our portion of that $41,946 from the utility bill was $22,860.72.
Well, as people said, we don't have that money in the budget. I think this is going to have to be subject of the meeting we had in January or February, when we're looking at the final budget for this year. And then one amendment, but we can't agree as well, so we don't have it.
This would be a perfect opportunity for the district to tap into their reserves.
we have, we don't have that kind of charter.
That's what we're doing.
I thought you had said over 15.
So, I don't know what the exact dollar amount is.
Yeah, one time you guys were requesting like.
We never got that, and we don't have that.
Like larger.
Like $150,000, I think.
Yeah, well.
We never got that.
That one is just like this board, and it is board.
True, the amount was, but there was still a reserve.
There's still this one, so could you come back next month with the actual in that reserve, and then do an actual, also look and see if there's any other possibilities here. And get a charge and charge, and get a couple of urgency there, right?
Yeah, and if we pay it in 2023, it would go to capital, budget for 2023.
So it's not gonna happen.
And it's crazy.
Okay, so, yeah, we're not gonna act on that one tonight. Okay, anything else?
No.
Okay, park committee report, we've one in the file. Yep. Still my original report, Wolf Lake Memorial Park report, Chad's not here, but is there anything other than we mentioned, Kim, about the skating rink, last news?